I'm Amy Austin. I'm an associate professor at the University of Buenos Aires in Argentina. I've been an editor at New Phytologist since 2008 in the environment section. And my career to date has been a little bit unusual. I did my undergraduate work in environmental sciences in Oregon in the United States, and then a doctorate at Stanford. And after that, with a postdoc and a continuing career, I moved to Argentina and have been working in Patagonian ecosystems. I'm by trade an ecosystem ecologist, but I've been really fascinated by sort of the interactions between soil organisms and plants. And I think that a lot of that comes from, I had a lot of brothers, and we, as children, we grew up in Florida, in the state of Florida in the U.S., and we were always outside. And I think that contact with nature, and especially where the weather is nice all year round, allows you to form a connection with the natural world that, that I think stayed with me throughout my life. So I was initially was actually interested in pursuing a career in international law and diplomacy, but perhaps that didn't seem quite the perfect fit for me. And I realized that I was very interested in plants and how plants worked. And also I became increasingly interested in how human activity affected the natural world. And so as I decided to start a career in science, I was very attracted to all of those issues. And I think one of the things about a scientific career is that you don't want to do it necessarily for the money, because the pay is not necessarily the best part about it. But the intellectual liberty that it gives you, the ability to choose the questions that you pursue, has been one of the most wonderful parts about being a scientist. A lot of people have role models that are important at different aspects of their life, and I certainly have had role models that have not been necessarily scientists or associated directly with my career, starting, of course, with my parents and people that were around me as a young person. But I do feel that that there were people that were role models for me for teaching in terms of being really inspirational teachers, and also mentors, including my doctoral advisor, Peter Vitusek, who really showed me enthusiasm and how it was to be generous in spirit with ideas and knowledge. And I think that has been something that I've tried to then transmit to students as I've become sort of the other side of the coin and teach and mentor students. My advice again would be do something that you're passionate about, and I think that's almost a cliche in that people always say that, but I think it's definitely true, because scientists and being in a scientific career is an awful lot of hard work, and it's a lot of time outside of the sort of regular 9-to-5 work day, and you have to love what you do. And so pursue questions that really interest you, do things that you like to do, and I think that's the best advice, because if you can maintain that enthusiasm, if you can really maintain the joy in what you're doing in science, that will transmit itself into a successful career. I think that most everything that has to do with being outside is what I love. I love to do hiking and camping, and I travel a fair amount because I live in Argentina, and so I have to generally go to faraway places when I visit people and do things. And I think that's a big part of what I like to do when I'm not in the office or in the field itself. So those are the things I like.